Today is the first time we take a look at an Aero 500 model. Let's see if it's any good. Hi there, Spectre here, and welcome back to a new review. And today we are taking a look at a Boeing 777-300ER from Cathay Pacific, made by Aero 500. And this aircraft came in here at Review Airport from Hong Kong. And as we can see right here, it is now taxiing towards its ramp, where a lot of equipment is already standing by to receive the aircraft, and also the fueling truck is already on its way. So with this aircraft just entering its turnaround, we sure have plenty of time to take a look at it up close. Alright, and here she is up close, the Boeing 777-300ER from Cathay Pacific, made by Aero 500. And it's the first time we take a look at a model of that brand, and let's have a look if it can stand up to the other brands we've seen on this channel thus far. And without further ado, let's start at the front of the aircraft, where we can see the cockpit windows are detailed quite nicely, and we have the window wipers included as well, but unfortunately no further details here. However, when we move on to the side of the aircraft, we can see loads of details which are printed on. For example, the pitot tubes near the cockpit for measuring airspeed and all that kind of stuff. And when we take a look at the nose gear, on the nose gear doors, we have some printed details as well. A red line and the last two letters of the registration code, which in this case are Papa Mike. And we also have the Cathay Pacific branding. And next to the first and second passenger door, we have the One World logo, of which Cathay Pacific is a member. And we also have the writing of Cathay Pacific along the fuselage. Now we can take a look at the engines, which have been given this bluish-grayish kind of color, which is the same color you can see on the fuselage of the aircraft. And we also have some nice detailing on here, the silver leaning edge, which we have with every aircraft model. But we also have a GE90 logo, which looks really cool. And we have a red line warning for jet blast. And when we look into the engines, we can see the engine fan blades. Then when we move to the back side of the engines, we can see it has been detailed pretty nicely. I must say this is one of the best detailing I have seen on an engine. And here we can also see the main landing gear of the 777, and I must say I have seen it better on other models, but still it looks quite decent. And now we can move on to the wings, or more specifically the top side of the wings, where we can see loads of details. Starting with the flaps, slats, spoilers and ailerons being carved out, although that could have been a little bit more pronounced, it's still quite good. And we have loads of printed details, for example as to where you can walk on the wing, and we have the markings for the emergency exits. And we also have two thick black stripes indicating the outer line of the main landing gear, which the pilots can see through a camera in the vertical stabilizer. And then when we move on to the underside of the wings and the belly of the aircraft, we can see the flaps, slats and ailerons once more. We can see the full registration code of the aircraft here on the right side. And on the belly we can also see some nice small printed details, which I really like. Now we can take a look at the back side of the aircraft with, on the vertical stabilizer, we can see the Cathay Pacific branding. On the fuselage we have the full registration code and the Swire branding, which is the company which is the largest shareholder in Cathay Pacific. And then here at the rear we can also see some detailing with the APU exhaust, which is important on any aircraft model if you ask me, and here it has been done quite well. And then also on the other side we have some details along with the cargo doors here at the back, which looks really good, and here at the front it also looks quite nice. Alright, so that's it for this Boeing 777-300ER from Cathay Pacific, made by Aero 500. And I must say, I love this one. The print quality is really good, we have loads of details, and the physical details are also great. However, this model is quite rare. If you want it, you might have to pay quite a big price. I was lucky that it was still available in my local store, but these days you would have to look on eBay, and prices are probably going to be high, as I said earlier. However, if you can get it at a retailer, it should go for about 40 euros, which in my opinion is worth it, considering the amount of detailing that you get for it and the quality of it. And in addition to that, I would like to say that this brand actually stands out above most of the other brands we have seen thus far. If you compare it to InFlight 500, it's about just as good. But if you compare it to the other brands, it's way better if you ask me. So if you like Cathay Pacific or the 777-300, then this one is definitely one for you to get. Now if you like this episode, you can show that by leaving a like, and you might even consider subscribing if you don't want to miss out on any future reviews. And if you have any suggestions for those future reviews, you can leave it in the comments below. And with that, I want to say thank you very much for watching. This is Spectre signing off, and I hope to see you next time.